guys. Welcome back to another episode of Dishwasher Talk. We're going to talk about cultural appropriation today, which is a mixture of two cuisines together, like the sushi burrito. I'm not a big fan of it. I think it's like, or just like people that will take cultural kind of things and they'll put Cheetos into it and they'll call it, you know, a dish in itself. But what's your opinion on like sushi burritos and that? Like a fusion of food that's like, I don't know, because like when the sushi burrito came out, there was like, people were doing like sushi in like burritos, but now it's like so altered that, you know, people are just putting stuff in like burrito forms in general. So what do you think about that?
I actually think it's actually not that bad. I think it's also a customer culture. So like, for instance, you're Vietnamese American, correct? And yeah. Also Chinese, part Chinese?
Yeah.
Okay, so your cultures are actually really close together. But since, you know, United States are a melting pot of different cultures, there are two cultures that actually do sometimes get together and like procreate, and then actually, I think it's more of a reflection of like two diverse cultures, and when I say diverse, I mean totally opposite sides of the worlds come together and bring it together, like their cultures together, and then all of a sudden there is a result of, you know, a sushi burrito. So, and then on top of that, there's also, you have to understand, there's different cultures that actually work together in restaurants all the time. Like, I mean, if you look at any sushi place in, like, Portland, it's all Hispanic people making sushi.
That's true.
So it's like one of those things, like, we can't really, I understand, like, I understand some people's, like, hesitation to be like, oh, that's, like, keep it, if you're going to say sushi, it has to be this. Food nowadays doesn't have that boundaries, and I think that's what's beautiful about it, is there's so many different cultures, and, like, if someone were to do, like, a Indian fried rice, technically that's Chinese and Indian put together. But you also have to understand, back then, like, food back then, like noodles, that was Asian. And Italy was like, oh, well, that looks awesome, let's do it with ours. And they started doing it. And then now, all of a sudden, Italy is, like, I would say the powerhouse when it comes to, like, pastas.
Yeah.
So it's just one of those things, like, it's not new as much as people think it is. I think it's definitely more accessible now that there is social media and those kind of like questions and like theories behind it, like cultural like immersions, like co-fusion. It's what is it? It's like Korean and like Mexican food.
Yeah, it is.
So it's one of those things like I'm torn because
it's a borderline of, you know, respect that you cross, like the Bon Appetit video when they did the pho thing. Did you ever watch that?
No.
It was like it was like one of the biggest outlash on a Bon Appetit video where a Caucasian guy was cooking pho, but he was cooking it like completely in like bastardized the tradition. He was cooking it like totally different, and then that the way that Bon Appetit cut the clips together made him look like he was like an awful person. And then his restaurant, like, people were just yelping in one star just because of this whole anti-social media thing. And so he had to actually apologize on his, like, to the newspaper and social media because, like, the Vietnamese community felt so, like, they were so outraged of what he was doing.
Definitely. And this is where I have problems. Mm-hmm. And, like, that right there. Like, if someone has a different way of doing things, I don't think, and I understand that there is a Vietnamese culture and there's a Hispanic culture and there's all these different cultures that have their, like, way of doing things. But to actually have someone who goes and sits there and says, hey, like, this is how I remember doing it when I was a kid, and for them to be like, oh, well, that's wrong. That's not how Vietnamese people do it. Then that's kind of one of those situations, that's kind of the borderline where you have to be like, whoa, you're eating on someone else's culture, whether it's their point of view. Then you're on that, like, it's like, oh, you're going to hate on this person because he's not doing it the way every other Vietnamese person does it. So, I mean, then you're kind of putting people in that part of, like, I'm going to spite you just because you're not doing it the way that majority of us are doing it. And that's wrong. I mean,
especially with, like, modern technology and, like, I think when you're, like, a chef, you're thinking about how the taste is, you know. Sometimes we don't think about how the whole entire culture plays together.
Exactly.
And now we have, like, sous vide machines. We have, you know, we have so much, like, just modern technology now that people want to explore what they can do with food, you know.
Definitely.
And, you know, there's always that traditional sense, but if you keep the traditional, as like a chef, we always want to grow when it comes to technique. Mm-hmm. And, you know, whatever items we use, so we always try to branch out of the, you know, the I guess the modern, we try to create like new gels and that. Some people think that it's weird to eat that kind of stuff, but it's like, is this how society based their head, you know, that we should eat food like this all the time? So.
I mean, well, the thing about like this, like the way, like, do you think it would be like people would get mad if we like said, hey, this is how you do your Vietnamese like short ribs in a sous vide? You think people would get mad? Like, oh, well, that's not how it's done.
I think like in my head, it's like, because I'm a chef, it's like, I think it's an awesome way. You cook it faster, you cook more, and I think it's like awesome. It'll taste a lot better. But then some people might say, oh, you're taking out the tradition of it, of having it on the grill and kind of stuff. But it's like, you know, everyone has their opinion kind of thing. And yeah. I'm also much younger than, you know, the first generation of Asian Americans that came here, or like, you know, my parents and that, who, like, when I talk about sous vide, they don't understand. Like, they're like, can't you just boil a hot, you know, a pot of water and just throw stuff in? But they don't understand the science of the circulation, exactly. And, you know, the temperature control, and that a stove can't regulate temperature like a sous vide machine does. So,
yeah. And I think it's also a situation of like, we as a culture are changing, especially as Americans. It's going to change because we are all speaking the same language. Mm-hmm. Like, our generation is all speaking English. I don't think there's really like anyone who's born in America that doesn't speak English. And it's now that we have that cultural like breakdown where it's like everybody speaks the same language. They may have a second language, that's totally fine, but we all can understand each other. We're gonna start taking things and tips from other people. I mean, there's tons of things that I've learned from Hispanics, and I'm like, oh, that's really cool, like how they make their sauces and how they roast things, awesome. And then there's things that I took from French, where like technique-wise, like that's most of my like cooking.
Most of the culinary skills branches off the French technique.
Exactly.
So.
And then Thai, Indian food, like vanilla, like how to roast spices and how to blend like different spices and actually make it kind of like taste good. I'm learning that through Indian cooking. Like there's all these different techniques, and I think if we limit to tradition, we're gonna always plateau.
This is coming from like a chef perspective. It's like. Like, our passion is to learn other people's craft and then develop that into, you know, somehow our own kind of craft. So, it might be biased in that sense, you know, that we are chefs.
Yeah, and I totally think that people who aren't in the chef world are just going to watch this and be like, oh, well, that's coming from chefs and everything like that. But you're talking about a 60-year-old...
Singular culture.
Exactly.
Individual who's lived that life their whole entire life.
Exactly. And they see that and they're like, oh, you're just bastardizing. I'm like... No, it's how I was taught from somebody else, and I said, you know what, I have a technique that makes do the exact same thing, either faster or easier, and you have a more consistent product, versus having to literally check on something every 10 seconds and learn through grandma how to make your pho, and how to wash everything, and like, all these characteristics. It's hard to teach that to other people, and it's just one of the things, unless you actually in that culture, and if you see a white dude making pho, and like
automatically in your head, if you see someone that's not Vietnamese, you automatically it's not good. It's just how your brain works and
exactly.
How the culture and society has Precious. You know taught all of us. So,
yep.
But yeah, that's our quick dishwasher talk. We didn't even wash any dishes because
oh
I think
gosh.
It was just
no,
a good conversation.
It's a good conversation.
Yeah.
You should actually see this dish bit real quick. Can I show the dish bit? We were cooking today, so we got some work to do. So, peace out, guys. God bless, and have a wonderful day.
That's a good talk.